You would always have my back, talking to customers for me, handle them for me while I make the drinks.
I was the cafe supervisor. I was overseeing things. And almost everyone that worked at that cafe had autism. And I remember there was this one employee. He was not very accustomed to talking with people. He would have this scowl on his face. But that was just how he was. And a customer came up and took his scowl the wrong way. He just got so mad. He was about ready to punch his lights out. And so I pulled the gentleman to the side and I explained to him, this employee is on the spectrum. And after I explained this to him, this man started crying because he didn't realize this. And so it really helped build my self-confidence up.
What were you like as a kid?
It was really hard for me to talk because I was always nervous.
What were you like as a brother to me?
I wanted to always protect you, man.
I appreciate you being my big brother.
You know what, Remmick? I don't know what I'd do without you, seriously, because I cannot stand being alone. That's actually my number one fear in life. I don't like being the last person to go to sleep at night. And for you to be there, I feel pretty blessed, man. To have a brother who shares something that you have, same kind of emotions, and it's hard for me to explain that, but you know what I'm talking about, right? It's just, I think it just means the world.